Milford police say an 8-year-old girl found a hypodermic needle in the sand. She picked it up and pricked her finger.
For the past 2 days, vials of blood, needles, and syringes have been found at popular beaches.
From dirty medical needles to bags and cups.
Yeah, it's been seen on beaches up and down the coast.
Lots of tubes, syringes. But what they're finding out there right now is just plain disgusting.
Hypodermic needles,
though. Saw the water just filled with trash. So
the surfer was stuck with a needle.
A lot of needles there. People can get pulled. You don't know what they have in there.
So it's not safe anywhere.
Maria says her daughter stuck her hand in a container filled with used flu vaccine needles.
Yes, he said needles. And check this out.
Police spent hours searching the beach for more needles and found four others along the high tide mark.
They should be in locked containers somewhere if they're not destroyed completely by incineration. So somebody isn't taking care of their trash appropriately.
A child is stuck from needles spilling from a sharps container onto the floor inside the doctor's office. Another child is injured, reaching into a sharps container inside a treatment facility. Needles are continuously washing up onto beaches from improper disposal. And even worse, the resale of used hypodermic needles are now a black market business in third world countries and the Middle East, causing an epidemic of HIV and hepatitis C. Medical Safety Solutions is dedicated to this simple fact. The only way to ensure a reduction of accidental needle stick injuries after it leaves a healthcare worker's hands is to completely destroy the needle after one use at the point of procedure.
Hello, I'm Dr. Jane Reed. I am a board-certified emergency medicine physician and have been treating patients in the emergency department for the past 13 years. I am here today to make you aware of a critical and increasingly serious problem occurring within the hospital environment. Accidental needle sticks are associated with a significant morbidity and can have life-threatening ramifications. This is a very real issue that I face on a daily basis and is a real risk for all healthcare professionals. Once a person is stuck with a used hypodermic needle, the testing cost for contamination is in the thousands, not to mention the mental trauma these healthcare workers and their families endure. Because of such an overwhelming and increasing problem, Congress passed the Needle Stick Safety and Prevention Act, signed into law in 1999.
I'm Karen Daly, President of the American Nurses Association. For 26 years, I was a staff nurse and loved my practice. I had a rewarding career and couldn't imagine doing anything else. But one day at work in the summer of 1998, I was stuck with a needle protruding from a sharps container. I didn't know it then, but my life was changed forever that day. A few months later, I learned that the fatigue, weight loss, and other symptoms that I was experiencing were due to hepatitis C and HIV that I had contracted from that needle stick. We succeeded in getting Congress to pass the Federal Needle Stick Safety and Prevention Act. The law, enacted 10 years ago, requires that employers provide safer devices to protect healthcare workers from sharps injuries.
Over a decade later, the problem still exists. After 9 years of research and development, Medical Safety Solutions Incorporated introduces the Sharps Terminator, a safe, cost-effective solution for preventing accidental needle sticks at the point of procedure. The hypodermic needle is inserted into the top of the unit. The blue light illuminates, indicating that the needle has made contact with the positive and negative electrodes inside the unit. This signals the healthcare worker to quickly and firmly press down and hold. The needle is pushed down, passing through the positive and negative electrodes, which oxidize the needle completely from the tip to the hub. The unit then activates the cutter, which removes the needle from the barrel and illuminates in ultraviolet light, inside the SWRF container collections tube for 10 seconds. Remember, there is no substitute for caution when handling needles. But with the implementation of new technologies, such as the Sharps Terminator, we can all help to make a more safe work environment and perhaps prevent someone down the line from suffering a catastrophic needle stick injury.